Hello and welcome to the second module of the STEM is Everywhere MOOC. In this module, we will discuss the importance of real-world problems in science, technology, engineering and mathematics classes. We will also feature actual examples of educational activities that connect the different STEM classes to real life. But first, let's explore why it is important to engage students in real-world problems. Studies around the world are warning us to the decline in the number of young people choosing STEM careers. For example, let's observe the 2015 OECD PISA study. It measured an average of 24.5% of students from the OECD countries who are expecting to pursue a STEM career. Last year, Randstad Research conducted a study to uncover key motivations, beliefs and perspectives of STEM-related topics among students aged 11 to 17. The study asked 1,000 high school students in the US. The study revealed not only a lack of students' awareness of what types of STEM jobs exist, but also a lack of personal connection to STEM professionals and how STEM jobs are defined. Almost half of respondents say they don't know what kind of maths jobs exist, and 76% reported not knowing a lot about what engineers do. 87% think people who study STEM work at companies like NASA. Far fewer associate them with mainstream consumer brands like Instagram and Coca-Cola. Students interpret STEM too literally. This is interesting because young people reported high enthusiasm for careers not explicitly defined as STEM, but requiring related skills, suggesting the need for broader education as to how STEM skills can be applied in fields beyond mathematics and science. There is also a lack of confidence in STEM-related skills among young women. Despite significant progress over the past several decades in young women's participation and performance in STEM subjects, a major gender gap still exists. Girls are 34% more likely than boys to say that STEM jobs are hard to understand. When Americans are asked why more students don't pursue a degree in science, technology, engineering, or mathematics, they are most likely to point to the difficulty of these subjects, according to a Pew Research Center survey. About half of adults, 52%, say that the main reason young people don't pursue STEM degrees is that they think these subjects are too hard. Smaller shares say the main reason more young people don't pursue degrees in STEM is that they think STEM subjects are not useful for their careers, or that they think these subjects are too boring. This is 12%. What is more, the dropout rate for STEM studies is very high on the university level. About half of students with the intention to earn a STEM bachelor's degree fail to earn these degrees within 6 or 4 years. By now, you might have guessed where I'm going with this. Remember the 2015 OECD PISA study I quoted in the beginning of the video? It also found that the time students spend learning and how science is taught are more strongly associated with science performance and expectations to pursue a science career than how well-equipped or staffed the science department is. This basically means that it definitely does matter how we teach science. Forbes also suggests to solve real-world problems during STEM classes as it brings STEM education and STEM careers closer to students. So let's hear what some of the teachers who contributed to the development of this course have to say.
Usually when you are with your group of students and you bring a real-life problem to the classroom, it's something they connect with, so they understand what they are doing, and so they are very eager to try solving it because they understand that the answer is important also to them.
Because if I say you're going to need physics, of course I'm a physics teacher. Of course I'm going to say that about my subject. The real question is when someone from the outside, a doctor, comes in and says, yeah, I need this to know to make sure that my patient is awake or alive after the surgery. I need to know about the lasers. I need to know about the gases so I can make him breathe during the operation. Well, that's where the STEM subjects came into real term. And over the years, I have expanded this to many other subjects, creating activities. And this is what really is all about. How to bring the STEM to the real life and how to bring the real life into your classroom.
Thank you.